Don't you think it's a bit surprising to realize that something as rich and creamy as soy milk can be made out of just soybeans and water? Well, today we're going to do just that. We're making soy milk. So let's get into it. To start, take 250 grams of dried soybeans. I'm using these dehulled and split soybeans. They're really convenient because they already have their hulls removed. The first thing for us to do is to clean the beans with some water. There's not much here, but we're just going to try to get rid of any soybean skin left behind. Just toss the beans with your hands and then drain the water. I like to rinse the beans a couple of times to make sure they're good and clean. After that, we're going to soak the beans in water for several hours. This will hydrate and soften the beans, making them easier to blend later, and it's also meant to increase the amount of proteins and solids we can get from the beans in our soy milk, as shown by this paper. Basically, by soaking the beans, we get an easier blend and a more nutritious soy milk. So, for soaking, what we're looking to get is for the beans to expand 2 to 3 times their original volume, or for the beans to absorb about roughly 110 to 120% more of their weight in water. According to a study done in 2003, at this level of moisture content, the beans end up grinding up much finer than if they were soaked less. Typically, soaking them for around 8 hours here at room temperature, which is 26 degrees Celsius right now, is enough. However, the time it takes for the beans to hydrate may vary depending on your beans and on your room temperature. If you live somewhere colder, then it may take much longer, as soybeans are slower to hydrate at cooler temperatures. Back to our soybeans. Here they are after 8 hours. Properly soaked beans should look like this. They should also feel a bit softer to press, like a squishy thing. This is our before and after beans side by side. You can see that after soaking, they've really swollen up. Now we can double check that the beans are properly hydrated by weighing the drained beans after the soak. I'll drain the beans using a strainer. Then I'm going to weigh them. Their original weight was 250 grams. We wanted for them to gain an additional 110 to 120% of their weight, so they should weigh around 550 grams or a little less. And that does seem to be the case. So they're properly hydrated and ready to be put in the blender. But just before we do that, let's talk about how much water we're going to add to these beans. This depends on how rich of a soy milk you'd like to make. I enjoy really creamy ones, therefore I have a bean to water ratio of 1 to 7. So for 250 grams of the dry beans, I'll add 1,750 milliliters of water. This makes a really nice thick soy milk, just like this, which is really nice for making tofu with. It is very creamy, and I suggest if you prefer a lighter version or perhaps one of medium richness, then you should add more water so that the ratio of beans to water is 1 to 9 or even 1 to 10. It'll be a lot lighter. It's best to figure out how much water you need first and then just continue. Once we know how much water we need, in my case, 1,750 milliliters, I'm going to chuck the beans into the blender. And then we're going to add a portion of the water. I'm adding something like 800 milliliters, give or take, which is enough to fill up my blender and cover the beans. Then let's just blend this for 2 to 3 minutes until it's become a very smooth, white puree. Make sure that it is very well blended. Large chunks of pulp aren't good. We can't extract as much soy milk from them. When it looks like this, I'm going to stop. Just switch the blender off. Now, this is a point where a lot of recipes would recommend you strain the puree. However, according to a paper from 2007, straining the soybean puree after we've cooked it leads to a thicker soy milk that has more major minerals such as calcium, potassium, and magnesium. In other words, we can extract more if we strain the milk out after we cook it. As a quick note, cooking raw soybeans is an absolute must, and raw soybean milk or puree should never be consumed. because despite the otherwise incredible nutritional profile of raw soy milk, they also possess anti-nutrients, which aren't good for us. A key one being trypsin inhibitors. To explain, trypsin is a kind of enzyme that's found in our digestive system. It helps us digest proteins. Trypsin inhibitors, as they're named, prevent this trypsin from doing its job, which is obviously not good for us. Soybeans contain these trypsin inhibitors as a defense mechanism against animals eating them. Heat inactivates these inhibitors. Boiling for just 20 minutes was enough to get rid of around 80 to 87% of the trypsin inhibitors in a study done in 2008, although the paper did mention variability in previous studies. As an additional bonus, cooking also sterilizes the resulting soy milk and rids it of some of that beany flavor, as it inactivates a chemical that causes the flavor. So while it smells very grassy and beany right now, after we cook it, it'll smell less so. The puree already looks smooth and fine, so we're now going to go straight to cooking it. So, just pour the raw soy puree into the pot, using the remaining portion of water to rinse out the blender, and just pour that in. I'm also using a non-sticked pot for this, makes cleanup easier, since any solids that stick to the walls we can slide right off. Set it on high, and we're going to bring it to a boil, making sure to stir very frequently to prevent the bottom from burning. The soy milk is going to foam up a little. Make sure to stay close just in case it gets too hot and foams too much. Sometimes the foam can actually spill all the way over, which causes a pretty big mess. It can happen really quickly, so don't underestimate it. Adjust the fire down accordingly if you see this happening. While heating, I'm also using this to scrape off the foam and then just discard it. Then we just wait until it boils. Don't be fooled by all the foam, it should come to a roiling boil like this. Once it does, we're just going to let that run for another 20 minutes. Again, I'm making sure to stir really frequently. Once that's up, I'm going to turn off the heat. As it cools, the hot soy milk will form a thin skin on top if you leave it be. You can just stir that back in while it's warm or pick it up to add to a dish. Then we're going to strain our cooked soybean puree. I'm using a cheesecloth to do so with another metal strainer underlying it. Transfer the cooked soy puree into the strainer. This pot is a little large, so I'm using a glass measuring cup to help me pour it in. Then, the best way to get all of the milk, I found, is to strain by hand. But since it's still piping hot, it's perfectly fine to leave it to cool for a while before doing so. When it's cool enough to handle, make sure you twist it in this way to extract the milk. You can get a lot of it out in this way. This is a really fun part, by the way. It's a very enjoyable sensation of creamy soy milk. I'm going to squeeze out as much as I can. Once there's nothing left to squeeze out, I'm just going to stop. Then, move the cheesecloth and strainer into another bowl. We can open up the cheesecloth, and as you can see, our remaining soybean pulp, also known as okara, is dry and crumbly. It's no longer got any soy milk in it, but don't toss it out. This okara is actually really good stuff. It's rich in dietary fibers, proteins, and vitamins. In fact, in a paper from 2013, it says that dietary fiber in okara was reported to be able to reduce blood fat and blood pressure, protect against coronary heart disease, prevent the occurrence of colon cancer, and more. I've also found that personally, okara tastes pretty great when cooked properly. There are a lot of recipes to add it into. So I'm going to put this in this bowl and store it in the fridge. Then we're done. Just pour the soy milk into a container to cool or drink it while it's still warm. You could drink it plain or try out different flavors such as the delicious matcha soy latte, chocolate soy milk, or this beautiful blue butterfly pea flower soy milk tea. You could also make tofu with it, which tastes super good. If you'd like to store the milk, then after it cools down to room temperature, you can refrigerate it for 3 days. And that's it for today. Bye!